गुड मॉर्निंग एंड अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीबॉडी, कैन यू हियर मी बेटा? गुड मॉर्निंग एंड अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीबॉडी, बेटा कैन यू हियर मी जनाब एंड हानिया? काइंडली रिप्लाई मी इन चैट बॉक्स, कैन यू हियर मी ऑल? ओके ओके, just give me a few seconds to admit all the students who are joining the class, then we are going to start today's lecture. Right now, okay, let me admit. Okay, the students who have just joined me in, like Arham, Ahmed, beta, can you hear me? Okay, Arham. Okay. Before I start my lecture, beta, I just want to introduce myself first of all. As you all know that first year teacher, English teacher was Mrs. Aksa. But from today onwards, I will teach you English, and my name is Aisha Adnan, and now I will be your English teacher. Okay, your timetable and your timings will remain the same. There is no change in your timetable or the timings. Only the teacher has changed. Okay, the rest of the things are same. Your days of English class, your time of English class are same. Only instead of Miss Aksa, now I, Miss Aisha Adnan, will teach you English literature and English language. So I hope, because the same thing I have uploaded on Google Classroom last night, I have provided my link as well, and via that link you have joined my class. So I hope you people are well aware of this thing now. Instead of Miss Aksa, I will teach you English literature and English language. Okay, so let's move towards the lecture now. Beta, today we are going to have our lecture number 21. Today we have lecture number 21, and date is 4th of August 2020. Achha, today we have our lecture of English literature. Why we are doing English literature? You all know the reason of this thing, because you all are having your English literature journals with you. You all are having your English literature journals with you. That is why we are doing English literature nowadays, because all the assignments you people will be able to do in your English literature journal. That is why we are doing literature nowadays, because your literature journals are with you, and it will be easier for you to do your literature assignments in your literature journal. But when on Friday and Saturday you will come to school and you will return your English literature journal and you will take your English language journals back, then we will do English language. I hope I am clear that on Friday and Saturday your English literature journals will be given to us for checking, and you will do your English language working on your English language journals when we will give you back your language journal. Okay, that is why nowadays we are doing English literature. So once again, today is your English lecture number 21, and date is 4th of August 2020. Okay, what is the lesson that we are going to study? Achha, one thing I want to tell you, class 9, beta, in English you don't have chapters. Whenever you make a title page in your journals, English copies, you are not supposed to write chapter number 1, chapter number 2, because these are not the chapters. These are lessons. I hope you are very well aware of the difference between the chapters and lessons. I hope you people are well aware of the difference between the lesson and the chapter. As for example, when you were in class 8, your play was having chapters, you all know. But now in class 9 and in class 10, these are not the chapters, these are known as lessons. Okay, for example, in chemistry, in bio, in physics, whenever you start, you are having your chapters which are having subtopics. These subtopics are known as chapters. But in English, in class 9 and 10, there are no subtopics. There is only one complete topic, which is known as lesson. So this is the basic difference between a chapter and a lesson. And today we are going to study our lesson number 8. And name of the lesson is The Role of Women in the Pakistan Movement. And page is page number 45. I hope till now you all have purchased your English books. If you have purchased your English books, kindly open page number 45 with me. Kindly open page number 45 with me, and we are going to study the role of women in the Pakistan movement. What kind of the role that women play with the men to get independence and a separate homeland? Okay? Achha, let me tell you, class 9, in my today's lecture, I have not included the complete lesson. I have divided your lesson in three lectures. Okay, I have divided your lesson in three parts, and these three parts will be covered in three lectures. So, in today's lecture, we are going to complete its first part, then in the second lecture, we will complete its second part, and so on. Okay, so let's start reading now. Class 9, beta, before I start reading the lesson, I want to inform you that you all should be very, very attentive. You all have to listen to me very carefully, because I will ask you the questions. I will randomly pick out any one name of the student, of any student, and I'll ask you the question. If you people will not answer me the question, then you may be marked as absent in my class. I know that you people are present, but if you will not answer me my question, then I will mark your absent. I'm telling you. So please be very attentive and listen me very carefully. Okay, so let's start reading now. You have already learned that Pakistan was established on 14th of August 1947. Before the British ruled South Asia, after about 100 years of the British rule, both the Hindus and the Muslims of India realized that they must recover their independence and do away with the rule of British. Okay, we all know that Pakistan was established on 14th of August 1947. And before the creation of Pakistan, who was ruling South Asia? British was ruling South Asia. And for how long did British rule South Asia? British ruled South Asia for about 100 years. Years. 100 साल तक ब्रिटिश ने साउथ एशिया पर हकूमत की थी. ओके, सो आफ्टर अबाउट 100 इयर्स ऑफ द ब्रिटिश रूल, बोथ द हिंदूज एंड द मुस्लिम्स ऑफ इंडिया रियलाइज दैट दे मस्ट रिकवर देयर इंडिपेंडेंस. 100 साल की हकूमत के बाद हिंदू और मुसलमानों के अंदर इस चीज का शऊर पैदा हुआ कि दे शुड हैव देयर सेपरेट कंट्री. They should get the freedom from the British rule, okay? Their independence and do away with the rule of British. Okay, what is the meaning of do away? The meaning of do away with, to deal with or to execute, okay? The meaning of do away with means to deal with or to execute. Yani ke kisi ek kaam ko shuru karna aur usko पूरे तरीके से निभाना, उसको मुकम्मल करना. ओके, सो आफ्टर 100 इयर्स ऑफ द ब्रिटिश रूल, बोथ द हिंदूज एंड द मुस्लिम्स ऑफ इंडिया रियलाइज्ड दैट दे शुड रिकवर देयर इंडिपेंडेंस एंड डू अवे विद द रूल ऑफ ब्रिटिश. डू अवे विद द रूल ऑफ ब्रिटिश से मुराद ये है कि उनको ब्रिटिश को इस साउथ एशिया से निकालना है, धकेलना है. इस काम को उन्होंने शुरू करना है और पूरे तरीके से मुकम्मल करना है कि ब्रिटिशर्स जो हैं वो साउथ एशिया से पूरे तरीके से बाहर चले जाएं. ओके, इन द बिगनिंग बोथ द हिंदूज एंड द मुस्लिम्स वर्क टुगेदर टू ड्राइव द ब्रिटिश फ्रॉम इंडिया. ओके, टू ड्राइव मींस धकेलना. इंडिया से साउथ एशिया से ब्रिटिश को बाहर धकेलना, बाहर निकालना. ओके, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इन द बिगनिंग बोथ द हिंदूज एंड द मुस्लिम्स वर्कड टुगेदर टू ड्राइव द ब्रिटिश फ्रॉम इंडिया. टुगेदर दे फॉर्म्ड अ पॉलिटिकल पार्टी कॉल्ड द इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस. बट सून द मुस्लिम्स रियलाइज दैट द हिंदूज हु वर इन मेजॉरिटी इन कांग्रेस एज वेल एज इन द कंट्री would never give equal treatment to the Muslims and would not share the fruits of independence with them. Okay, first of all, they were working all together to drive the British from India. But later on, and for this purpose, they have made a party, political party, which was known as Indian National Congress. But very soon, Muslims have realized that Indian National Congress was having Hindus in great number as compared to the Muslims. हिंदुओं की तादाद मुसलमानों के मुकाबले में कम थी उस पार्टी में. And the Muslims realized that Hindus will not share the fruit of independence with them. Okay? So when they realized this thing, they formed their own political party and called it the All India Muslim League. Many Muslim leaders who had earlier joined the Congress party now left it and became members of the Muslim League. अच्छा, बहुत से मुस्लिम लीडर्स ऐसे थे जिन्होंने पहले कांग्रेस ज्वाइन कर ली थी, लेकिन जैसे ही उनको ये रियलाइज हुआ कि भाई कांग्रेस जो है वो तो मुसलमानों के फायदे की कोई बात सोचती ही नहीं है और मुसलमानों का की जो तादाद है वो कम है उस पार्टी में, दे फॉर्म देयर ओन पार्टी. और उन्हीं लीडर्स ने जिन्होंने पहले कांग्रेस ज्वाइन की हुई थी, उन्होंने वापस मुस्लिम लीग को ज्वाइन कर लिया. इन 1934 Qaid-e Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah became its president. Acha, there are few things which you have to learn very, very carefully. For example, this thing, this date you have to learn. When did Qaid-e Azam become president of Muslim League? Qaid-e Azam became the president of Muslim League in 1934. Beta, ye wo cheeze hain jo aapko MCQs mein puchhi ja sakti hain. These questions can be given to you in the form of short question answers or in the fill in the blanks. Please learn this date that in 1934, Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah became the president of Muslim League. Achha, ek aur cheez jo aapne yaad karni hai, aapko ye bhi pucha ja sakta hai ki for how long did British rule South Asia? This can be asked from you in the form of MCQs, in the form of fill in the blanks or in the form of short question answers ke bhai British ne kitne saalon tak South Asia par hukumat ki thi, for how long did the British rule South Asia, and the answer is for about 100 years. Okay, for about 100 years the British rule South Asia. Acha, yahan pe do objectives aa gaye jo maine aapko bata diye. Number one, the British rule for about 100 years. British rule South Asia for about 100 years. And number two, in 1934, Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah became its president. Okay? Acha. Now, I want to ask you a question. Who is going to give me the answer? Why did Muslims make their own political party? What was the reason of making their own political party? Who can give me the answer? Hurry up. Why did Muslim League make their own political party? What was the reason behind this? Hurry up. You people will answer me, then I will move forward. I know that you people know the answer. Hurry up, beta. Class 9, are you there? Are you listening me? Abiha? Abiha, beta, answer me. Why did Muslim make their own political party? Hania? Zarnab, you all are there, beta. Kindly reply me. It means nobody is listening me. Should I mark your absent now? Class 9, should I mark your absent now, I think? Very good, Jehan. Very good. Zarnab, very good, beta. They have made their own party because they realize that Hindus won't share the equal fruits of independence. Very good, Zarnab. Keep it up. Jehan, your answer is also very good, beta. Okay, let's move forward now. Okay, so it was very difficult to make the British realize that they had to consider the demands of the Muslims before they decided to give independence to India. A long and hard struggle followed. Not only did the men take part, but women also actively participated in their glorious struggle. Okay, what is the meaning of glorious? Glorious means magnificent, delightful, wonderful. Koi zabardast, shandar. Okay? Glorious means magnificent, delightful, and wonderful. Women also actively participated in their glorious struggle. At that time, our women were in strict parda. They were less educated and less politically aware than the Hindu women. But there were a number of brave and selfless women who, in spite of these hindrances, what is the meaning of hindrances? Hindrances means hurdles or obstacles, rukawatein. Okay? So, in spite of these hindrances, came forward and worked for this noble cause side by side with men. Acha, what is the meaning of side by side? Urdu mein hum log kehte hain na shana bashana. This is called side by side. Yani ke mardon ke shana bashana, auraton ne bhi usi tarike se kaam kiya to get a separate country, to get a freedom from Hindus and the British. Okay? Acha. First of all, obviously it was very difficult for the British ki wo is cheez ko realize kare ki bhai musalmanon ke bhi koi mutalbaat ho sakte hain, musalmanon ke bhi koi huqooq ho sakte hain. Jabki ye baat to bahut dur ki thi ke musalmanon ka ek alahda mulk hoga. Ye cheez admit karna, is cheez ko confess karna, is cheez ko realize karna Britishers ke liye ek bahut mushkil kaam tha. Wo is cheez ko hi manne pe taiyar nahi the कि मुसलमानों के भी जायज हकूक हैं, उनके मुतालबात हैं. कहां वो इस चीज पर मानते कि मुसलमानों को एक अलहदा मुल्क दे दिया जाए. सो दिस होल स्ट्रगल वॉज अ वेरी लॉन्ग एंड हार्ड स्ट्रगल. बहुत ही ज्यादा मुश्किल किस्म की ये एक मुस्लिम मूवमेंट थी, स्ट्रगल थी टू गेट अ सेपरेट कंट्री और अ फ्रीडम. ठीक है. अच्छा, अब इस फ्रीडम में, इस मूवमेंट में नॉट ओनली डिड द मेन टेक पार्ट बट विमेन आल्सो एक्टिवली पार्टिसिपेटेड. ये वो मूवमेंट थी जिसमें सिर्फ मर्दों ने काम नहीं किया, विमेन आल्सो इक्वली एक्टिवली पार्टिसिपेटेड इन दिस ग्लोरियस स्ट्रगल. इस शानदार किस्म की कोशिश में, इस अजीम कोशिश में औरतों ने भी मर्दों के शाना बशाना काम किया. Women also worked side by side with men in this glorious struggle. Okay? At that time, our women were in strict parda. अच्छा, ये सबसे बड़ी बात थी कि उस वक्त जब ये struggle चल रही थी, जब ये तहरीक चल रही थी, our women were in strict parda. बहुत सख्त किस्म की पर्दे की पाबंदी करती थी हमारी खवातीन. And they were less educated and less politically aware than the Hindu women. Acha, if we compare both the Muslim women and the Hindu women, our women were less educated, our women were in strict parda, and our women were less politically aware. Na to hamari auraton ko zyada ke paas zyada taleem thi, na hi unko zyada malumat thi siyasat ke bare mein, aur wo parda bhi bahut sakht karti thi, jabki jo Hindu women thi, they were एजुकेटेड, वो पढ़ी लिखी थी और उनके पास सियासत से मुतालिक ज्यादा मालूमात थी एज कम्पेयर टू मुस्लिम विमेन. तो हम ये कह सकते हैं कि हमारे लिए बींग अ मुस्लिम हमारे लिए बहुत ज्यादा हर्डल्स थी, बहुत ज्यादा ऑब्स्टिकल्स थी, बहुत ज्यादा चैलेंजेस थे, उसके बावजूद आवर मुस्लिम वुमेन केम फॉरवर्ड, आगे बढ़ी एंड दे वर्क फॉर दिस नोबल कॉज साइड बाय साइड विद मेन। उन्होंने इन तमाम रुकावटों को, इन तमाम मुश्किलात को पीछे छोड़ते हुए मर्दों के साथ मिलकर काम किया, शाना बशाना काम किया, किसी भी चीज में वो पीछे नहीं रही ये सोचकर कि मैं तो औरत हूँ, मैं तो लड़की हूँ, मैं कैसे करूंगी। नो, दे वर वर्किंग इक्वली साइड बाय साइड विद मेन फॉर दिस नोबल कॉज। ओके, इज दिस पेज क्लियर क्लास 9? क्लास 9, इज दिस पेज क्लियर बेटा? ओके, अच्छा, हु इज गोइंग टू गिव मी द आंसर कि व्हाट वर द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ मुस्लिम वुमेन वर देयर इफ वी कंपेयर बोथ द वुमेन, द हिंदू वुमेन एंड द मुस्लिम वुमेन, गिव मी द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ मुस्लिम वुमेन। मुस्लिम वुमेन की क्या खसूसियात थी, क्या कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स थी? Who is going to answer me? Please give me any 3 characteristics of Muslim women. Any 3 characteristics of Muslim women. Okay, characteristics number 1 is they were in strict parda. Number 2, they were less educated. Yes, Sanna, very good answer, beta. Very good. And they were less politically aware than the Hindu women. Very good, Janab. I'm really happy you are giving me very good answers. Keep it up. Okay, so now we are moving towards page number 46. Page number 46 is, let's start reading page number 46. They formed the women's branch of the Muslim League to organize women and inform them about the politics of the country. Yes, Abiha, very good, beta, very good. Acha, now, one important point that Muslim League was having 2 branches. One branch was for men and the other branch was for women. Okay, now I can ask you the question, what was the need of making a branch for Muslim League? Auraton ke liye Muslim League ki branch banane ki kya zarurat thi? Obviously, this was needed to organize women and to inform them about the politics of the country. Okay, ye question aapse pucha ja sakta hai short question answers mein ki what was the need of making the women's branch of the Muslim League. Answer is the women's branch of the Muslim League was needed to organize women and to inform them about the politics of the country, taaki ek to unko munazzam kiya ja sake, unko organize kiya ja sake aur fir unko सियासत के बारे में, पॉलिटिक्स के बारे में तालीम दी जा सके, मालूमात फराहम की जा सके। ओके, दे ट्रेवल टू द कंट्री साइड टू टेल द वुमेन देयर व्हाट दे शुड डू। अच्छा, अब जो जिस तरह मुस्लिम लीग के मेन थे, जो लीडर्स थे, इसी तरह मुस्लिम लीग वुमेन की भी लीडर्स थी, खवातीन। जिस तरह मेन लीडर्स थे, इसी तरह वुमेन भी लीडर्स थी। इन लीडर्स ने क्या किया, They traveled countryside, दूर दराज के इलाकों में, देहातों में ये लोग गई। Why did they go there? They went there to inform the women how they could participate in this noble cause. कि वो उन औरतों को जाके बता सकें कि भाई आप इस तहरीक में कैसे हिस्सा ले सकती हैं, आप क्या रोल प्ले कर सकती हैं। ओके, they organized public meetings for women and addressed large gatherings. और इन्हीं women leaders ने पब्लिक मीटिंग्स अरेंज की और तकारीर भी की. ओके, एड्रेस लार्ज गैदरिंग, बहुत बड़े बड़े मजमू के सामने तकरीरें की, उनके सामने अपनी ज़रूरियात रखी कि ये जो हम लोग अपने अपने जो उनकी डिमांड्स थी उनके सामने मुसलमानों के रखी कि हम ये मूवमेंट क्यों कर रहे हैं, हम इतनी स्ट्रगल क्यों कर रहे हैं, जस्ट टू गेट अ सेपरेट कंट्री फॉर आवर सेल्फ, टू गेट अ सेपरेट कंट्री वेयर वी कैन प्रैक्टिस आवर ओन वैल्यूज, आवर ओन नॉर्म्स एंड ट्रेडिशंस. ओके, सो दीज वुमेन लीडर्स ऑर्गेनाइज्ड पब्लिक मीटिंग्स फॉर वुमेन. इन्होंने मीटिंग्स अरेंज की जहाँ पे तमाम औरतें जमा होती थी, एंड एड्रेस लार्ज गैदरिंग्स, और बहुत बहुत बड़े बड़े मजमों के सामने तकरीरें भी की. ओके, दे ऑल्सो टुक पार्ट इन पब्लिक मीटिंग्स ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय मेन एंड मेड स्पीचेस बिफोर लार्ज ऑडियंसेस. अच्छा, ना सिर्फ इन्होंने वो पब्लिक मीटिंग्स अटेंड की जो सिर्फ औरतों की थी, उन्होंने वो पब्लिक मीटिंग्स भी अटेंड की जो मर्दों की थी. इन्होंने बिल्कुल भी औरतों ने इस चीज़ में ये नहीं सोचा कि मैं तो औरत हूँ, मैं लड़की हूँ, मैं मर्दों की मीटिंग में कैसे जा सकती हूँ. नो, देयर वॉज नो डिस्क्रिमिनेशन, देयर वॉज नो डिफरेंस बिटवीन मैन एंड वुमेन मीटिंग्स एंड पार्टी, देवर सेम, देवर इक्वल. द वुमेन ऑल्सो अटेंडेड द मीटिंग्स ऑफ मैन एंड दे ऑल्सो मेड स्पीचेस ऑल्सो, और इन्होंने उन मर्दों के सामने स्पीचेस भी की और उनकी मीटिंग्स को भी अटेंड किया. दे मेट वाइव्स एंड डॉटर्स ऑफ द ब्रिटिश ऑफिसर्स इंक्लूडिंग दोज ऑफ द वाइसरॉयज एंड मेड देम रियलाइज दैट देयर डिमांड वॉज जस्ट. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ जस्ट? जस्ट मीन्स फेयर, इंसाफ पर मबनी होना. ओके, जस्ट मीन्स फेयर, इंसाफ पर मबनी होना. अच्छा, अब इन मुस्लिम वुमेन लीडर्स ने क्या किया? दे मेट द वाइव्स एंड डॉटर्स ऑफ द ब्रिटिश ऑफिसर्स. ये ब्रिटिश ऑफिसर्स की वाइफ से और उनकी डॉटर से मिलती रही ताकि उनको ये बता सके कि जो हमारी डिमांड है, जो हमारा मुतालबा है टू हैव अ सेपरेट कंट्री और होमलैंड, इट इज जस्ट. ये इंसाफ पर मबनी है, ये कोई नाजायज बात नहीं है जिसका हम मुतालबा करें, ये जायज मुतालबा है. एंड यू शुड एडमिट दिस. दे ओपन क्लासेस इन देयर ओन होम्स टू एजुकेट मुस्लिम गर्ल्स. अच्छा, ये तो मैंने आपको बताया है कि एट दैट टाइम मुस्लिम वुमेन वॉज लेस एजुकेटेड, कम पढ़ी लिखी थी, इतनी ज्यादा तालीम नहीं थी. तो इसका सॉल्यूशन कैसे निकाला गया? दीज मुस्लिम लीडर्स ओपन द क्लासेस इन देयर ओन होम्स, यानी कि उनके जो घर थे वो स्कूलों में तब्दील हो गए थे, टू एजुकेट द मुस्लिम गर्ल्स. सॉल्यूशन क्या निकाला? दे ओपन क्लासेस इन देयर ओन होम्स टू एजुकेट मुस्लिम गर्ल्स. अच्छा, समटाइम्स द पुलिस वुड यूज टीयर गैस, टीयर गैस जिसको उर्दू में आंसू गैस कहा जाता है, एंड वुड लाठी चार्ज द वुमेन्स मीटिंग्स एंड इवन अरेस्ट देयर लीडर्स. अच्छा, यानी कि इतनी मुश्किलात इन खवातीन ने उठाई कि कभी कभार जब इनकी मीटिंग्स हो रही होती थी तो पुलिस आंसू गैस का इस्तेमाल करती थी, पुलिस आंसू गैस छोड़ देती थी, और यहाँ तक कि पुलिस ने लाठी का भी इस्तेमाल किया है और इन खवातीन को उस लाठी से पीटा गया है. और जिस तरह मेन लीडर्स को अरेस्ट कर लिया जाता था, इसी तरीके से मुस्लिम विमेन लीडर्स को भी अरेस्ट कर लिया जाता था. सो we can realize now ki how much struggle and difficulties these muslim men and women have faced to get a separate country, wo country jisme hum log aaj reh rahe hain, wo country jisme hum log aaj azad hain, wo country jiski hum aaj koi value hi nahi karte, jisko hum aaj koi importance hi nahi dete. agar hum log apni thoda piche jaye, if we move back and we study our history, तो हमें मालूम होगा कि हमारे ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स, हमारे बाप दादा परदादा ने कितनी तकलीफ उठाई टू गेट फ्रीडम, टू गेट अ सेपरेट कंट्री. ना सिर्फ मर्दों ने बल्कि वुमेन आल्सो वर्क साइड बाय साइड विद मेन. ओके, अच्छा, क्लास 9 टिल हियर इट इज क्लियर टू यू? आई होप इट इज क्लियर टिल हियर, टिल पेज नंबर 46. Okay, now I'm going to ask you a question. Who is going to give me the answer of this question? How did Muslim women get education? Who is going to give me the answer? How did Muslim women get education? Because they were less educated, we all know. How did Muslim women get education? Who is going to give me the answer? Who is going to give me the answer? Hurry up, beta, I have to move forward. How did Muslim women get education? The Muslim women got education because the Muslim women leaders opened classes in their own homes. Basically, the homes of Muslim women leaders were transformed into school. So school mein tabdeel ho gaye the. That is how Muslim women got education from those schools or from those classes. Okay? Okay, let's move forward. Acha, in your English book, you have some study of structures, means idioms, phrases, and a question is given to you in your paper. 6 marks hote hain is question ke. This question carries 6 marks. Very good, Abiha, very good. Acha, listen to me carefully now, class 9. In your English book, lots of study of structures are given. A 6 marks question is given to you in which 6 phrases or idioms are there, or aapne in phrases ko ya in idioms ko sentences mein use karna hota hai. You are supposed to use these structures or idioms in your sentence making. Acha, jab tak aap logon ko inke meanings pata nahi honge, you will not be able to use these structures in your sentence making. So it is very important for you to learn the meanings of these structures first. Okay, so first of all, I am going to make the sentences. Later on, you can also join me. Okay, let's start making the sentences. First of all, looked after. What is the meaning of looked after? Obviously, looked after means to take care of. Kisi cheez ka khayal rakhna ya dekhbhal karna. I am making a sentence. My sick mother is looked after by me. The next sentence banaya. My sick mother is looked after by me. Isi tarike se aap bhi bana sakte ho. Okay. Very good, Zarnab. Very good. You have made a good sentence, beta. Anybody else? Acha, now see structure number 2. Look for. What is the meaning of look for? Look for in search of. Kisi cheez ki talash mein hona. For example, main ek sentence banati hu. My brother is looking for job now our day. My brother is looking for job now our days. Mera bhai aajkal naukri ki talash mein hai. My brother is looking for job now our days. Koi aur bana sakta hai look for ka sentence? Isi tarah ek aur sentence mere dimag mein aaya. I am looking for the pen that I have lost yesterday. Main us pen ko talash kar raha hu jisko maine kal kho diya tha. I am looking for the pen that I have lost yesterday. Last 9, these structures are very important and this question carries 6 marks and you are supposed to use these structures in your sentence making. Don't take them lightly or non-seriously. Very good, Zarnab. Very good. Only Zarnab is making sentences. I don't know what other students are doing. Okay, look into. Look into, aap aksar application likhte hain aur end mein aap ek sentence likhte hain. We request you to look into the matter. So look into ka matlab hai kisi cheez par gaur karna, kisi cheez ke bare mein sochna. Okay, Abiha, very good. Who is going to make the sentence of look into? Okay, I am making a sentence. The concerned authorities are requested to look into the matter. The concerned authorities are requested to look into the matter. Look out. The child was looking out the car's window. बच्चा गाड़ी की खिड़की से बाहर देख रहा था. The child was looking out from the car's window. Look at. Very good, Zana. Very, very good sentence you have made. The government should look into the problems of the country. Abhiha beta, you have not used the structure of look into. You have to make the sentence of the structure using look into. Acha, look at ka kaun banayega sentence? Jaldi se kijiye beta, we are left with 3 minutes. Look at. The teacher asked the student to look at the board. Point at, किसी चीज की तरफ इशारा करना. The child pointed at the broken window. The child pointed at the broken window. I hope this study of structure is clear. Sentences are very important for you to make, but before making sentences, you should know the meanings of these structures, okay? Acha, what is your to-do task? What you are supposed to do? You have to read this lesson very carefully and thoroughly. You have to learn the meanings of the difficult word. I will upload the assignment after my lecture. You have to do the assignment in your literature journal. Beta, don't write chapter. Kindly write lesson. This is your lesson number 8, not chapter number 8, okay? Kindly make the title page of the lesson and maintain the index. Beta, maintenance of indices is very, very important. You all know that your assignment carries 10 marks. All these things are including in 10 marks. For example, in maintenance of indices, making of title pages. If you will not make indices, if you will not make the title pages of the lesson, you may lose your marks. Okay? So please be very careful about all these things. Index should be maintained, title pages should be there, work should be done very neatly and carefully. Okay, so class 9, everybody has marked the attendance. Nobody is left, I hope. All of you have written your present in the chat box. Farjad, you have not given even a single answer, but for attendance, you have written present. If you were listening me, why didn't you answer me, Farzad? Beta, I've asked questions, sentences, but you haven't answered me even a single one. Sign, you have also not participated, Beta. Why? I hope everybody has written the attendance. Nobody's left. Hurry up. Okay, till my next lecture, better take very good care of yourself. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you and Allah Hafiz.